It's a lot about that TV show, man, that got people confused. Because I live with my grandma. You know, we'll go to the house on like the weekend. They'll say, hey, we shooting today. We need y'all at the house. They'll come get me from my grandma's house. And right after we done, when the cameras go off, I'm right back to my grandma's house. Mm.
The announcement that Ty and Tiny will soon be grandparents thanks to their son King Harris is undoubtedly making waves, especially in light of the drama surrounding King's fiancée, the Big H. There has apparently been a gap between King and his girlfriend, with many remarking that she seems a lot older and others even comparing her age to his mother Tiny and Ty, who is renowned for being quite protective of his family. Not pleased with this circumstance, not only is the age gap a cause for worry, but there are also rumors that King's girlfriend may be a money digger who is more interested in King's celebrity and fortune than in a sincere relationship. Connection. Since Ty and King's relationship has already been strained for some time, this new development may only make things worse between father and son. This is especially likely to happen if Ty believes that King is making decisions that will negatively affect his future, and that the public and family dynamics will not be happy with. Make this a constant topic of conversation, especially given the additional strain of their already complicated relationship. King Harris approached his father directly, accusing him of mistreating him as a child and of being a no-show. This happened only hours before. For those who haven't kept up with this drama, it all started at the Atlanta Falcons game when King got into a fight with a random guy that Ty went into to de-escalate but ended up holding King in a headlock after they had a heated altercation. That's when things really heated up. I stood on the business. Ty stepped in again, trying to check King, telling him he was out here embarrassing himself and the whole family with all that yelling, acting tough and playing gangster, but King wasn't having any of it. Word on the street is that King acted as though he couldn't care less that his pops was stepping in and kept on yelling full throttle. After the video went viral and King posted on his Instagram story, saying, "I stand on business, I don't give a f who you are m evers," it was necessary to put him in a headlock to remind him who's the father and that he best show some respect now. "Can't play in my face, I'm a mature man now. If I make a mistake, simply own up to it and stop making others believe that you're in love with me when you're not, for the benefit of those who don't know." In addition to being Ty's kid, King Harris is attempting to establish himself as a rapper. Despite having a rather ordinary upbringing, he has been promoting the idea that he came from nothing. Despite the fact that King is wealthy and has a history of acting flamboyantly and attempting to flex like other rappers who actually came up from the streets, let's face it, we all know King can be a little bashful. This isn't the first time he has been out here going crazy and trying to flex like that. You guys remember when he attempted to show off to the Waffle House employee, acting all powerful and superior simply because he was Ty's kid and treating the employees like they were beneath him, making threats and acting like he ran the place. Daddy is well known, and let's not forget how he displayed no regret after being called out for that shady stunt involving the homeless man. He dared him to take on the tacky chip challenge without drinking water for 5 minutes, and the poor man, who was suffering from the heat, eventually gave up. He lost, but of course the king had little consolation prize for the man like that was supposed to make it all better. He should have apologized, especially since that chip is already banned, but nah, he was feeling too big to own up to his mess now. Well, we're all quick to drag King for going toe-to-toe with his pops and acting a fool. Let's not sleep on what he posted on his Instagram story. He laid it all out clear as day. "If I'm mistaken, just say that. Stop making the world think you f with me when you don't. So get this, King wasn't just some spoiled rich kid like Ty and Tiny tried to make us believe during that showdown. Sure, he had all the luxuries money could buy, but he was raised by his grandma right in the heart of the hood, not behind some fancy gated community. Even though his parents made sure he never lacked anything financially, his grandma's place was smack dab in the hood, and guess what, he had the freedom to run with whoever he wanted and hit up any spot he pleased. So making friends and living that hood life. That was King's today for real, and it just keeps getting messier when you find out that he only hung out with Ty and Tiny on weekends while they were filming that TV show. Once the cameras were off, he was right back at his grandma's house. Furthermore, it turns out that none of the children we saw in the family hustle house were actually living with them full time, so King wasn't the only one living apart from Ty and Tiny. Rumor has it that when Zanique crashed at Tiny's mama's place, she spilt the tea that revealed Ty and Zanique were always stuck together. But here is the good part. While filming in that opulent mansion, viewers are conjecturing about King, who may be disparaging his parents because he is experiencing a severe identity crisis, and making fun of themselves. He's depressed and young, having based his identity on his father, but he has to find his own identity. He acts tough and makes an effort to seem like he knows all these significant people. Before it's too late, I hope he realizes that he did the right thing for his disrespect. He investigated the area where the man had insulted him. This is what happens when you indulge kids and never discipline them for misbehaving. Ultimately, they will treat you badly and reveal to you what other people are talking about. This thing is so ridiculous and awful, everyone. It's stunning that King Harris is fighting with his own father, and it's insane that Ty simply up and stopped being there for all of his kids. Please share your opinions in the space provided below, and don't forget to visit this link to check out. In this other dramatic video, King Harris approached his father directly, accusing him of abandoning him and mistreating him as a child. This incident occurred just hours after they had a heated argument during the Falcons game. For those who aren't aware, this whole issue started during the Atlanta Falcons game when King got into an altercation with an unidentified man. Chai tried to de-escalate the situation, but that's when things became really heated and King acted like he continued to yell at full throttle, completely unaffected by his parents intervening. Standing on the bus, I tried to check on King again and told him that his outburst of ranting embarrassed the entire family and himself. Acting tough and playing the gangster, but King was having none of it. Rumor has it that King had to be put in a headlock to remind him who the father is and that he had to start treating people with some dignity now that the video had gone viral. Instagram story and shared, "I don't give a damn about who you are, I stick by my business. I'm a mature man now, so money cannot toy with my face. If I make a mistake, I just have to admit it and stop creating." For those who don't already know, the world believes you are infatuated with me when you're not. In addition to being Ty's kid, King Harris is attempting to establish himself as a rapper. Lately, he has been promoting the idea that he rose from nothing. Hood artist vibe had a very wealthy upbringing despite. Let's face it, we all know King can be a little bashful, and this isn't the first time he's been out here acting crazy and trying to flex like that. He's trying to persuade people that he had it hard, just like those rappers who actually came up from the streets. You all remember how tough he was when he tried to show off to that Waffle House employee, acting all haughty because he was Ty's son and talking down to them as though they were beneath him, making threats like he owned the place because his dad is famous. And let's not forget how little regret he showed when people called him out for that shady stunt in which he dangled $50 in front of a homeless man. Of the man challenging him to the sticky chip challenge without drinking water for 5 minutes. The poor man was suffering from the heat and ultimately lost, but naturally, the king had a small token of comfort for the man, which was meant to make everything better. He ought to have apologized. While we're all quick to criticize King for going toe-to-toe with his parents and acting foolish, let's not sleep on what he posted on his Instagram story. He laid it all out clearly as day, so if I'm wrong, just say that. Especially since that chip is already banned, but nah, he was feeling too big to own up to his mess now. Stop pretending that you agree with me when you don't, and realize that this king wasn't simply a pampered wealthy child like you. While at the showdown, Tiny attempted to convince us that he had all the comforts money could purchase, although he was reared by his. The location of his grandmother was in the middle of the neighborhood, not behind a posh gated community, despite the fact that his parents ensured he never experienced financial hardship. King's day-to-day was truly about making friends and living that hood life because he was free to run with whoever he wanted and go wherever he pleased. However, it gets even messier when you learn that he only hung out with Ty and Tiny on the weekends while they were filming that TV show. He returned straight to his grandmother's house when the cameras were turned off and there's a lot regarding. It turns out that none of the children we saw in the Family Hustle house were actually living with Ty and Tiny, so King wasn't the only one who lived with them. Moreover, rumors are circulating that when Zanique crashed at Tiny's mama's place, she spilt the tea that Ty and Zanique were always sticking together. But here is the good part. Fans are guessing and making assumptions about King, who appears to be having an identity problem as he struggles to choose between the opulent mansion they were filming and his own family. They are young and depressed. He based his identity on his father, but he has to find his own identity and follow his own path. He presents a rough exterior and attempts to project the impression that he is well connected. Before it's too late and Ty, I hope he finds out, did the proper thing to show him where he had mistreated him. This is what happens when you lavish kids and never discipline them for misbehaving. Ultimately, they will treat you badly and mimic what other people are saying about you. All this stuff is just horrifying and wild. The fact that King Harris is at odds with his own father is really disturbing. That takes craziness to a whole new level when he just up and leaves all of his kids. Please share your opinions in the space provided below, and don't forget to follow this link to view this additional dramatic film.